All right, welcome to the Breaking the Mold podcast. I am joined today with an absolute legend. I am joined today with the owner of Height Digital Manchester, Logan Hughes. Logan is a great friend of mine. He has been pouring knowledge into me since me starting my agency. And I'm super stoked to have Logan on the podcast. Everyone, welcome Logan. Thank you, Logan, for joining us.
What's good, man? Yo, so thanks for having me on here.
Absolutely.
First and foremost, the setup is ridiculous. Anyone
if you who build
has,
it.
Exactly, right? Yeah. Anyone who has seen the videos you've been posting about the podcast studio itself lives up to everything that you said.
Awesome. So appreciate that.
A lot of great work, man. I'm excited to see all the content that gets created here and the guests you have on here.
Yeah. Got a good lineup coming.
Yeah, it's super legit, man. So thank you for having me.
And you get to be the first guest.
I know.
What an honor, literally, to be you in this honor. You know, this is great.
It's big time.
This is great. Yeah. So why don't you tell everybody here. So I started a Facebook group, right, specifically modeled to people in the trades. Either you're a technician or you own a HVAC, plumbing, electrical, roofing, general contractor, whatever it is. If you have a service that you're providing a client, I wanted you in this group because there's a lot of knowledge. You know that I've been in the industry for 15 years, customer service, marketing, general manager stuff. So there's a lot of knowledge that we could pour into. And I know you have a heart just like I do, right? That you just want to just pour out as much knowledge as you can. And you strive on seeing others succeed. And I know this personally because you have done that to me. You continue to do that for me. And I really appreciate that. So why don't you tell everybody, you know, really who you are and what you specialize in and what you do.
Yeah, man. So thank you for that. It's been a long road for the agency side of things for myself. I started, so backtracking a little bit, I was working as a in medical device sales in Boston for 7 years. And I was doing a lot of inventory management for them and running into hospitals and so forth. And although the job was very secure, I felt like my soul was being literally sucked from my body, right? I'm a very creative person at heart. I graphic design, graduate graphic design, music and everything, and just someone of creative nature. And it got to the point where I had to make a move. And I found an ad by someone called Ty Lopez, who, if you're in the marketing space, you know exactly who this guy is. He's been around forever. I saw an ad for him about talking about, you can do social media management for companies. And I was like, well, this is great. I can start, you know, using some of my design capabilities that I actually graduated school with to actually help business owners out. And that steamrolled into me really creating at the time a quote unquote agency. I think at the time I was doing a lot of like freelance work, but I ended up finding my way into website design. And that was really kicked everything off. Being able to work directly with the business owner, build something that is going to not only look beautiful, but actually work for their business is really where everything sort of came together. So I ran my agency for around 2 years or so, 2.5 years. And luckily I found, Hike reached out to me and we went through the process of going through this whole franchising deal. It was a whirlwind of a couple months, flew to Nicaragua and trained with, you know, a lot of the people down there, met the team, got, you know, incorporated with the culture itself. And,
you know, I started to see that you were doing that and I thought you were absolutely crazy because I did see, well, first I was like jealous, like, look at you in Nicaragua. This is sick. You were posting some pictures, but the picture I remember you seeing, like, This agency makes sure that their franchisees are legit and that they are aligned with their values. And I now know Height because of you and stuff like that. Great company, great organization for you to be a part of. Yeah. But one thing I remember seeing was you in that ice bath.
Oh, yeah.
And as we know now on social media, right, anyone that chooses an ice bath is going to be a millionaire someday. So we're in the presence of a future millionaire here because he has been in ice bath. Have you invested in one yet?
No, not yet. If I had the space to do so, I probably would have. Yeah. But no, you're absolutely right, man. I mean, Height, they definitely bring in people who fit within the culture and what their values are. And that's something that was extremely important to me when becoming a franchise owner in itself was, do I align with the culture? Is it going to be a really good place to work? And everyone down there is just not only amazing, but extremely knowledgeable. Mm-hmm. So feeling incredibly blessed to be a part of that group and everything that that comes with it. So yeah, and then here we are, you know, so I've definitely grown a lot since merging with them. We have a really great team in place and still trying to provide unmatched services from a marketing strategy perspective, but also just being a normal human being who just wants to help others out. So.
Yeah, I think one thing I love about, you know, being able to work with you and which we'll get into because we do have clients that we work together on, is that, you know, you also with your agency, you do also focus a lot on the trades, right? With roofing and electrical companies, plumbing companies, HVAC and stuff like that. Yep. And a lot of people would be like, Matt, you're crazy. Why are you having this guy on? He's a direct competitor of yours, right? But the thing that we've come to know and something that I'm grateful to figure out early in my agency is that there are so many businesses out there. There's so many opportunities out there that when you start thinking of everybody as a competitor, instead of looking at, you know, another agency that's just trying to serve and help local businesses. And I think a lot of HVAC companies, plumbing companies, anyone in the trades, if you have that mentality of that everyone is a competitor, you're just going to drive yourself absolutely crazy. You're going to get in your head. You're going to be spending way too much time searching what they're doing, and you're not focusing on you. You're not focusing on your values. And that's something that you've actually helped me with as well. With when I first started off, and you know, we were talking because, like I said, we'll get into working with Spark Electrician Services. But I do remember telling you, be like, man, look at this guy. He's stealing all my ideas. And you're like, dude, don't dwell about that stuff. Dwell about that stuff because one, it's the agency space. There's not much to talk about. We can talk about websites, SEO, social media management, PPC and stuff like that. There's only a core value of things that we can talk about. So at some point you're going to think someone's stealing your content, but we're really just talking about how to serve and help local businesses. Mm-hmm. And that's one thing that I love working with you directly. And when I was the operations manager at Spark Electrician Services, we needed marketing help. I was knowledgeable in the field, but I obviously wasn't running an agency at that point. I knew what we needed to do and what we were struggling with, right? Mm-hmm. And you were a huge help jumping in. And this is when you were seventh level, right? And we got to witness just your growth within that time. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Spark has been blowing up, dude. Yeah. Spark has been blowing up. And all credit to us.
none to those
hard-working electricians that go in every day, value what they're doing, value their customers. And I think that's really important too. So I'll hit on that real quick is like when you hire an agency and when you're talking marketing, if your marketing agency has better values than you do and you're not lined up, there can be a disconnect there, right? So it's really important that if you don't have a mission statement, vision statement, values and stuff like that as a business, just go back and get that, right? Because it's important to have an agency that's going to be lined up with that, right? And lined up to see you succeed.
Yeah, and it's ultimately a partnership between two businesses, right? And I think it works both ways with marketing agencies and business as well, because believe me, I'm sure you've had previous clients too where they sort of see you as an employee of their business. They might talk to you certain ways or, you know, ask you to do things immediately and you're like, whoa.
Yeah.
Right. Let's take a step back and sort of reevaluate where we're both coming from. And that's that partnership that I think we both sort of, you know, preach to other businesses. It's a partnership.
Yeah, for sure.
We are helping you out.
For sure.
You're helping us out. And we need to have constant communication and building this relationship. And ultimately, you know, I think that's where some marketing agencies absolutely fall short. They're keen on sales, they're keen on selling, and their churn rate super high.
Yeah.
The retention's really, really low. So that partnership is so, so important to me personally, you know?
Yeah, for sure. And I think when I was working at Spark, right? And this is a story I tell often is, you know, we were trying to build relationship with our customers before coming out. So that's when I started kind of inventing marketing on the move before it was so popular and cool. And I would be going out to seeing our technicians, taking pictures of them and just trying to build trust. And that became popular, right? Mm-hmm. So we started picking up some steam with this marketing stuff. And that's when we're like, all right, we need to dabble a little bit more. Can't just be Facebook, right? Facebook, I think, is just like a great branding tool.
Sure.
Show people who you are. People go to your website to find out what you do. They see on social media really who you are, what your values are, and stuff like that, right? So they work well, really well together. And you ended up building us a brand new website for Spark because it just was not up to par.
Right.
It was very old. I can't even remember what it looks like.
I think it was on Squarespace or Wix or something.
Yeah, which guys, if you have a Wix, Squarespace website,
GoDaddy.
You need some help. I mean, they work. It's an easy to create templated website. You get something up there, and that's step one. That's great, right? Yep. If you need to do that, that's great. You need to have something up, right? But if you're looking to get to the next level with SEO, with content, you definitely need to upgrade as your marketing strategy upgrades.
Certainly.
And that's taking it off of Wix, off of GoDaddy, off of Squarespace, getting a WordPress website where you can just master your SEO presence, right? So that's one thing that we did with you, and you killed it. Still kill it. We still are going in there making edits and updates. Don't set it and forget it. Don't set and forget your website. Consistently add content, blogs, change SEO, change keywords, change pictures around. Just keep it updated for sure. That's a big thing. But we also started to see growth with just their phone calls, technicians growing. And it's been a really cool experience just to see how far they've grown from when we first started their marketing strategy.
It's been a really great experience working with you and Justin and Keith and the team over there. They're just really great people. And it just all worked out. And, you know, again, kudos to Justin and Keith and yourself for keeping things rolling, because a lot of this stuff takes time, right?
Yeah,
and
for sure.
As business owners who need to generate revenue, right, pay the employees and do the whole thing, they want to see things happening relatively quick, right? We've been working with them now for I think several years at least, at least a year and a half, and they believed in the process, you know, and it's a testament to their belief in trusting the process and following through with it, right? You have some clients and sometimes where businesses, you know, after several months are just willing to throw in the towel. And I guess there's many circumstances that come into play with the reasoning why. But if the agency is doing what they're supposed to be doing, communicating properly, telling you that this is something that could take a little bit longer, you know, I would say, you know, believe in them, right? Because, you know, hopefully these agencies are doing what they should be doing. And it takes time.
Yeah.
Right? And over time, now they have a sustainable process for generating leads where they don't have to rely on referrals or word of mouth. Those are great things to have, right? Probably some of the best leads to get.
Yeah, for sure.
If you're solely relying on those and you're just waiting for that next call, that's a really, really tough position to be in. And they don't literally have to worry about that anymore.
Yeah.
So, yeah, kudos to those guys.
Yeah, I mean, you often see so many agencies out there make promises that we in the agency, you know, business understand they're just absolutely, you can't keep those promises.
Yep.
So we'll say if your agency, let's list off a few promises that we just know that agencies cannot, you know, provide, right? And I think the first promise that comes to my mind is, you know, promising that within a month you'll be blowing up, right? This SEO strategy is gonna blow up for you in 30 days, right?
Yep.
We both know it can take 3-6 months, a year for a proper SEO strategy to really get in the swing of things, right? We've heard agencies say their communication's really well and then you never hear from them after 3 months, right?
That
the set it and forget it mentality that agencies can get when you're dealing with a lot of people that are not local,
right?
You have no idea really where they're out of. Their website says they're based in Texas, but they don't sound like they're from Texas,
right?
So you know what I'm talking about. What are other few things that you might see that are just absolutely red flags when someone in the trades is looking for a marketing agency.
Yeah, I think the big thing is how many leads can be guaranteed for the business, right? From a marketing perspective, it's really, really difficult. And I try, as crazy as this might sound, to shy away from telling a business owner, hey, we can get you so and so many leads per month. There's many factors that comes into the lead generation process, right?
And you probably get a million Facebook messages a month, right?
Oh, well, I mean, go to any Facebook group and there's like, I can guarantee you 15 to 20, 100 leads a
month. Can you handle another 30 calls a month?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
For sure.
Right. So,
and we know you're getting those Facebook messages, especially the ones that I'm doing their social media. I'm seeing those messages.
Yeah.
They come around. I would say you get one a day.
Yeah.
Oh, can you handle, do you do residential service?
Right.
Do you do commercial service? Right. Can you handle another 50 leads per month?
Right. Right. Yeah. That's played
out. Bogus.
It's played out. It's but that's, you know, and it works both ways, right? The marketing agency itself should, leads are ultimately what we want to get.
But
there's so many different factors that come into play to that. So what we would advise or look to do is to set up a strategy that will eventually get to the point where the leads are coming in and you don't have to worry about that, right?
Yeah.
1 month starting up, it could be low. The next month could be high. The next month could be a medium range. It could be a dip. And we're always constantly testing and adjusting what strategies work best. It's never, you're never gonna find an agency that can deliver that many leads. And if they do, and they say they do it, I can almost guarantee you that these are very unqualified leads, right?
Yep.
So when we talk about lead generation, we need to have conversations with the business owner around how many leads you're looking for a month, you know, how many can you close, you know, what's ideal cost per conversion or cost per lead, taking all those factors into place and then developing a strategy around that. Because most importantly, again, you know, we could get you 100 to 200 leads.
Yep.
You know, Spark is at 250 right per month right now. But it's been on us to be able to qualify those leads, because if 250 leads is great, wow, that's a huge number. But if, you know, 249 of them are unqualified or spam,
right,
what's happening here, right? So it's all about the qualifying leads and so forth. So that would be my biggest one.
Yeah, for sure. How often do you hear when you're working with a new client, right, that one, oh yeah, the last agency I had, it was so good for 3-6 months, and then communication really started lacking, and it was, they weren't getting back to us, or we're performing and stuff like that. That's just like, that's just making so many promises out the gate that sounds so good that you have no other option other than say yes.
Yeah.
And then it just dwindles down. And that's what I've seen anyways, just being in the space for a year and a half now, talking to people. And the other one is, well, let me say this real quick, right? Just, and this will resonate to the people that are in this group, because you're not always the cheapest HVAC company, plumbing company, electrical company out there, right? And the thing that I know by working in the trades for 15 years, you cannot stand when a customer gets upset over your pricing, right? You value your pricing, you put a lot of work into it, you put a lot into work into training, overhead, technicians, office staff, whatever it is, you put a lot of time and effort, and you have to really be comfortable with your pricing, right? So when you give an option that so-and-so costs $500, when that customer's like, that's too expensive, that's absurd, you're like, okay,
right,
I trust this price. I know this price has value in it. And if you can't see it, then I'm sorry. Maybe the salesperson wasn't able to build enough value, or the technician, whatever it is. But that's the same thing for marketing space, right? Like, oh man, your marketing agency is so expensive. Or you always go with the cheapest option. You don't want your clients and your customers going for the cheapest option. So why would you hire the cheapest option for your marketing? And that's a huge struggle in it, and something that we always have to overcome, right? Because we know our value. We know we're not going to overcommit, overpromise anything.
Yep.
What we'd rather do is just be completely authentic, be completely upfront and honest with you, and come in and just blow those expectations out of the water.
For sure. Yeah, all that is absolutely true. The one thing that I would add to that is when we're talking about dollar signs, we need to be able to have a measurable ROI to make any sense whatsoever.
Right.
Right. If if a business is operating, you know, $150,000 a year, technically speaking, a business should put 7% or so of annual revenue right. into marketing, right? So
yeah.
you're talking about a couple thousand dollars here to utilize for marketing, right? So mm-hmm. what does that look like? You know, do you not have as a website on Squarespace? Are you looking for SEO? Well, if you're looking for SEO, but you have a Squarespace, Wix, Weebly website, you know, you're not going to be able to get.
Yeah.
So you're basically wasting a lot of that money where it could be invested in something else. So we are very, very, very ROI driven when it comes down to any strategies. And there's been times where I've had to tell the business owner, hey, we need to start either here or we really can't mm-hmm. do anything at this moment because,
yeah.
you know, if we're selling, you know, Facebook ads for $9.98 a month with additional ad spend that the client has to take care of, but their services is, you know, $50.
Yeah. Right.
What's the ROI going to be on that?
Right.
Right. Yep. So again,
for sure.
any marketing agency probably out there would be like, hard sell, let's get them mm-hmm. in the door.
Mm-hmm.
But if it doesn't make sense to the business owner, then it's ultimately not going to work out.
So yeah.
That's
yeah. very important. So another big thing, right? And I know this breaks your heart every time you hear it, right? Is when you get a new client and you come to find out they do not own the rights to their own website that's probably yeah. been up for years, mm-hmm. right? They don't own the rights to their website. So mm-hmm. I know, you know what? I'm just going to give you the floor with this one because I yeah. know you're passionate about this one. I know you just recently posted about it.
Yeah.
It instantly just, it's a gut punch, right? Every yeah. time you hear that,
yeah.
they don't own their yeah. their website.
Yeah. And listen, I don't want to turn this into a, you know, an agency bashing session here. But what I wanted to, the post I put out the other day was basically wanting to hold accountable people who are not doing things for the right reasons.
Mm-hmm.
And it's getting to a point now where I've consistently talked to business owners weekly, and around half of the time when we're talking about just websites in general, they don't know if they own it, or they come mm-hmm. to me and say, hey, I'm in a situation where this agency, if we shut off their hosting or if we shut off this $250 a month SEO package, that they lose their website. Meaning if they leave them, the website that this agency built is gone. They're out of nothing. And when it comes down to just doing the right things for business owners, every
yep.
owner should have the rights to their own website.
Absolutely.
Right? You should have admin access to it. That should be your property. Now, you know, there's some businesses where possibly this renting model makes sense from an agency perspective, but for me, it's never like that. And again, time and time again, this comes up, and it just really, really irritates me because we're in a situation right now where
yep.
a domain is being locked up.
Yep.
We can't get access to it. We can't move it over and actually host the website at all. The website's down, and that type of deal, that whole scenario too, is just a whole thing in itself, right?
Yeah.
So if you're a business owner, if you're watching this, my suggestion would be to look immediately into, if you're working with the agency, ask them if you were to shut down services with them, is your website gone?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you have yeah. actual login information to your website and to your domain? That would
yeah.
be the biggest recommendation I have for someone right now.
Yeah.
Because we're seeing it so often. And again, I don't talk too much about this, but when a business owner is just getting started, they're looking for any help they can get.
Right.
Most of the times it's the cheapest, you know, thing they can get their hands on, and they just don't know. Right.
Yep.
So, and that's another fault of the market agency. Market agency should be able to communicate and be transparent with their services and products.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a big,
yeah, it's tough. It's so hard when, I mean, think about if you're a consumer and you need a HVAC company mm-hmm. and you go on Google and you click their website option and it's not there.
Right.
Right. It's just gone. Mm-hmm. Right. There's nothing there. It says error code 403 yeah, yeah. or whatever it is. it's terrible. That's yeah. instantly someone that's not going to call you.
Right.
Right. They might think you went out of business.
Yeah.
And it's, yeah, it's not good if your website has to go down for any reason. And that's one thing that like you said, just a minute ago, with something we're dealing with, unfortunately, yeah. for one of our clients that is just in a poor situation right now that we're trying to rectify and help them out with. But and we'll get it rectified, and we'll help them out with, and we'll get them up and running, and they're going to do amazing things because they got the good marketing mindset right now for their business. Reviews. Let's talk about reviews for a second. It's obviously crucial to get reviews for your business. So I'll let you speak into that. I'm going to speak first into, responding to reviews. Right? Because I think a lot of businesses out there have a great amount of reviews, but Google loves when you respond to your reviews. You got to respond to your reviews. Don't go on there and just say, thanks, Mrs. Smith. Thanks for that 5-star review, Mrs. Smith. Right? If you're working in the business, you know what you did for that client. It's very important to be like, Mrs. Smith, thank you so much for your review. We are so pleased that you are happy with your new HVAC. What am I trying to think here? Let's go with a water heater because that's easy. That's on my mind right now. I don't know why, but Mrs. Smith, we're so glad we're able to come out to Concord and get that new water heater installed for you. Thank you so much for using Ryder Plumbing and Heating. We can't wait to service you again, right? You talked about the location, the service, and the business name in that review, which are just three amazing keywords that you have in that. And that's something Google is going to just eat up and absolutely love. And 100%. That's for every single one of your reviews, responding to every single one of those. Don't let one go untouched. If there's a negative one, respond to that negative review in a professional way. Don't bash the client. Don't do any of that. Respond in a professional way. So when people go on there and they see that you have a negative review, because let's face it, we're going to have a negative review at some point, right? If clients can see how you handle that negative circumstance, it's going to just build confidence and trust, right? Instead of just getting super defensive, because I've seen that and it kills me. Like, you don't know what you're talking about, Mrs. Smith. You know, we came out there and did this. If you don't like our prices, find someone else, whatever it is. It's just like, oh man, you can't be doing that. You know, you're a professional establishment. Act in a professional manner. And just badmouth that client afterwards to your other peers. I'm kidding. Don't do that. Be kind to everyone. But getting those reviews is crucial. Something, Spark started hammering hard when I was there and stuff like that. Something that we're really focusing on and driving heavy is getting those 5-star reviews. The more you have, when you get that 1-star review, it's not going to affect you. Right? If you only have 10 reviews and you get a 1-star review, it's going to destroy your reputation. You have 500 reviews and you get a 1-star review, it's barely going to do a dent.
And I think too, like, you know, I know you and I both get calls when a bad review comes in for a client, and by all means, it's a very sucky feeling, right? Like, totally. You never want to be having to deal with that. You know, for the most part, you always want to be able to deliver the best customer service you can ever possibly.
It's even worse when you get a 1-star review for cutting someone off on the highway.
Exactly.
It happens, right? I'm sure anyone can relate to that. You may not even service this client, but they just, you cut them off by accident on the highway and they write you a bad review.
Something along the lines
of that. It's unfortunate.
But here's the thing though, is that consumers are also looking at the fact that if a business has 500 5-star reviews, there's something weird going on there, right? Now businesses are able to literally buy reviews for their businesses.
I've seen that, the little bots.
So if you do have one and your rating's 4.5, 4.6, 4.7, whatever it may be, that's all, you know, I try to always flip the mindset around on that, because, you know, consumers are also looking at that being like, something isn't right there, right? It looks good, but who knows what the business owner is actually doing. So,
It's I've seen those just recently. And it's, you can tell.
You can tell.
If we can tell, Google can tell, right? And they're going to start cracking down on it. Just like Facebook and Instagram crack down on when you buy followers, right? They know. They know, and they're gonna, it's gonna mess with your algorithm. It's gonna make you rank lower and stuff like that. Google's gonna catch up on this if they haven't already. I'm sure they have. Google's amazing, but I've seen that all the time. Fake profile picture, very. It can either just be a 5-star with no description, or the description's very like ChatGPT-ish right there, and even the responses are not even the the business. The responses are also fake.
Yeah.
So you can tell. So don't be authentic, right? Yep. Like you have to be authentic. If you're a local business, you have to be authentic because you just want to build value. Mm-hmm. You're not building value by buying your way to the top. It's just going to come to bite you in the butt in the long run. Let's talk about, I have 200 reviews. Let's talk about Spark. Mm-hmm. All right, let's jump right into the awesome win we just had because of your brilliant, brilliant mind. Spark had how many reviews?
They had, say it was 259 at the time.
259. Have you ever been told, hey, I left you a 5-star review and you're like, oh, I never saw it come in, right? That happens. Google might put some reviews into Google jail, into review jail, right?
Yep.
It might have been a great review. Bots are causing this, guys. This is the outcome of bots, right? Google's trying to crack down on this stuff. Yep. So there's some reviews that are real and authentic that you worked so hard for that 5-star review, right? It could be hard for a technician to ask for a 5-star review.
Yeah.
But the other tip I'll also give, and I'm backtracking here, that's just how my mind works, is that if you're looking for reviews and you need to get reviews, the biggest selling point is having your technicians ask while they're on the job site.
Yes.
The second that technician leaves, the likelihood of getting that review drops like half, drops like 50%. Right? The customer's on a high. You just fix their situation. You're the superhero. They're so pleased with everything. Capitalize, ask for a review. Logan has a great template that he can send you for capitalizing those reviews with as easy as a QR code, right?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, and I took the strategy from, honestly, from, you know, what you did with Spark, right? I mean, you, I don't, at the time, I'm not sure if this was, you know, planned out, but, you know, I think when we mentioned, maybe correct me if I'm wrong, but I think when Spark, when you were working there, it was like 50 or something along the lines of that, right?
It was under 100.
It was under 100, yeah. So within, I don't know, less than a year, they've grown to 100, 150 reviews.
Yeah.
Based on the strategies that you implemented, right? And it's
those guys were killing it getting those reviews.
Yeah, and it's something that I was, when we're talking about reviews, I'm like, man, this needs to be, we got to emphasize this whole entire strategy. And it is incredibly easy to set up. I created it's a free template on Canva. I'm sure everyone out there has Canva. If not, it's free. And it's a super easy template. It's a business card that basically has a QR code on it. Backside just has basic business information. But to your point, you know, after a job is completed, when the customer is on a high note, and you're ready to pack up, just slip them this card, be like, hey, we'd love to, you know, get your feedback on the work that we've done. All you have to do is scan the code here to leave us a review. We'd love your feedback, right? And more than enough, they will do it at that instant while you're cleaning up, or, you know,
absolutely,
getting ready to leave.
Yeah, right? I always say give it to the customer during your cleanup process.
Yep.
Right, while you're cleaning up, because if they run into a problem like, hey, it's not working, whatever the case may be, or if it's, you know, listen, there's a lot of people that are technically challenged, right? Even if it's as easy as scanning a QR code, they might not have their Google account on their phone, whatever
Stuff,
and you can help them walk through the process of leaving that review. Don't just leave it and expect them to do it. Follow up, ask them about it. Did you have a chance to leave that review? Do you have any questions about that review? And always tee them up like, hey, listen, I hope you had a pleasurable experience with us. I'm glad we're able to fix your situation. If you were to rank us between 1 and 5, what would it be? And they're like, oh, absolutely 5. Like, oh, we'd love to hear that.
Yeah.
Please, here's scan this and leave us a review either on Google or even Facebook. You know, definitely Google's number one.
Yep.
You want to rank that up. Once you get 500,000 reviews on there, you want to throw some to Facebook to start ranking there a little bit better. Go for it.
Right.
But definitely want to push your Google presence for sure.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So I have a free template that's available. Just send me a DM message, you know, anything in the group. I can get that over to you. I'll send you over a quick video tutorial on how to change everything out. Again, it's incredibly easy. Within 5 minutes, you'll have, you know, a really good strategy for your business. And recently I just implemented this within a painting business in Exeter. And I think within a week they had 5 new reviews.
Yeah.
Right. And you mentioned something too that's also important is the follow-up process, right?
Definitely.
So, we've noticed and we've we've ran some tests on this is that the conversions on someone leaving a review goes up, I can't remember, it's 30-40% on the third time that you ask them, right? So the first time that you initially try to get the review, you know, it's pretty low.
And this is after the call, this is a day or so afterwards, you're following up?
Exactly. Yeah. The second time, you know, they will be, okay, you know, I'll get to it, don't worry.
Yep.
It's that third time where they're like, okay, I need to do it. And in fact, what's funny about that is I had a client that we just launched a website for. We did their branding and so forth, logos and everything. Went through the same process. Messaged them once about the review, get to it. Messaged them twice, get to it. Got the review today. This was the third time I did it, right?
So yeah, don't give up.
Don't give up.
Don't give up.
Chase them down. Because another really essential part of this is, as everyone knows, Google reviews are important for just branding trust, right? Again, if you go online, plumbers near me, finding out who has the best reviews, super important. But Google just recently changed their algorithm within the last several months, I believe, and they put more of an emphasis on ranking factors due to Google reviews.
Nice.
Right. I think beforehand it was around 11%. Now it's around 15%.
Wow.
So they're putting more, putting a more emphasis on that. So the more that you can get reviews, quality reviews, leaving really good structured replies, the better your local SEO is going to do.
That's so important, guys. We'll listen, you got to bring this home. Like, you have to reply to these reviews. It's so crucial. It's almost like they're non-existent if you're not communicating. And it's just as Facebook, Instagram. If you're not communicating to the community and not responding and not engaging, it hurts. Sure. It can hurt you. So it's as easy as just replying. If you have a customer service rep or if you're even the owner doing it all, just sit down, take 20 minutes, reply to all of your reviews.
Yep.
If you haven't already, say you've been in business for 7 years and you have 200 reviews, you haven't replied to any of them, start. Yeah. Just start knocking off 10, 15 a day or something like that. Just start responding to them.
And if you do that, check your performance in your Google My Business page, because I can almost guarantee if you have, you know, let's say 50, right? Or even lower, maybe like 20 or 10, right? I can almost guarantee that there would be an uptick in website traffic
for
because of that, right?
Yeah.
Especially when you're using location, service keywords, branding keywords, and so forth, and there I apply, right?
Yep.
There's so many little hacks that you can do with Google My Business page it's just really.
And these are free tips. This is something you don't have to hire an agency to do. You can handle this yourself. You just need to be very intentional with it, and you need to just jump on it and do it. There's absolutely no excuse not to do it.
Right.
You just need to.
Yep.
It's crucial for your business to rank organically if you're not having a huge Google or SEO strategy going on. This is just something a new business can do. Just do it.
Yep.
Just do it.
Pretty much.
Okay. Hopefully our mics were on when we said just do it.
Exactly.
Come on. Don't come after me, Nike. Let's talk about reviews that are missing.
Mm-hmm.
We have seen with Spark, you know, you started saying, hey, listen, you know, how many reviews do we think missing? Because it's an ongoing thing. People have said that, right? And they had 259 reviews, right? And then you went in and you got them freed.
Yep.
You paid the debt for those for those prisoners to be released.
Yeah.
And it brought us to 300 reviews. Yeah. 41 of them.
Yep.
Out of 259, 41 of them were in jail, in Google review jail.
Yep.
And you know, that's something that we want to help with, something Logan can help with is freeing those up. So not only does he have the template that's for easy access to leave behind for the QR code and stuff like that, but if you need help unleashing your reviews that have been your friends and family or customers have promised that they've left and they're not there,
right.
Drop your email in the comments. And we'll reach out to you and we will help you get those freed.
Yeah, absolutely. Send me a message. Let's connect. This is something that, you know, I think everyone who is trying to generate reviews on Google has come across a time where so-and-so left me a review. I'm not seeing it. What's happening, right?
Yeah.
Like, it happens so much. And the process is relatively easy. It can take up to a week. One thing that we would just need access to is your Google My Business page. Just that's really it. From there, we'll take care of it. But yeah, let's get those reviews back.
Yeah.
Because, you know, not, I mean, Spark already was crushing it reviews.
Yeah.
But I mean, just think about the amount of jobs and additional revenue coming in based mm-hmm. off of those reviews
yeah,
alone.
For sure. Like
that 259 to 300, that's a huge
so
difference.
Valuable too.
It's incredibly valuable.
Think about like the one thing that we did with Spark to get the huge bump in reviews was we were spiffing our technicians.
Yeah.
Right. So yeah. we would either give a direct bonus, like, hey, this month you get 0 to 5 reviews, you get $20. You get 5 to 10 reviews, we'll give you $100.
Yeah.
And so on and so forth. Or we would be like, hey, listen, you get a review, we drop your name in a hat, and yeah, at the monthly meeting we pick a winner.
Yeah.
We started implementing like a big wheel we would spin and stuff like that that had a bunch of different prizes on there that yeah, they can win. So think about that, right? Think about spiffing your technicians a few $100 each technician.
Sure.
Say you have 4 technicians and you're spiffing them each $200. That's $800 you spent on getting reviews, mm-hmm, right? If 40 of those go missing,
right?
What's so it? True. What's yeah, it yeah, worth it?
Right.
So we're gonna offer that, right, for $500.
Yep.
For customers to for you guys, discounted rate of $500 to get your reviews freed up.
Yeah.
Right? No, sure. That's not even it. That's not even it, guys. Think about how much you would pay to have 40, 50, even 10 more reviews
yeah,
tomorrow.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. And this guy right here, like I told you in my little Facebook post, a little secret here, it's going to be free to
yeah,
the people in
free,
this group.
100%. Yeah. So like I said, you know, we want to, with this group, we definitely want to bring some value here and do things for the right reasons. And you know, ultimately, you and I are both service first, right?
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
Bring that first and foremost. So whatever we can do to help, and yeah, don't let those hard-earned reviews go to waste. So if you have, even if you think it's one, right, maybe you're missing one review,
mm-hmm,
let's get in touch. Let's see what we can do to get those back and
yeah,
get you in good standing. Because who knows? There could be 2, there could be 10, it could be 15, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's go ahead and get those done.
I mean, in this group, I know for a fact there's a few guys that have been in business for years.
Yep.
Probably just as long as Spark has,
right?
You know, and if you have those that are hidden, or if you don't even know, mm-hmm, what's there to lose?
Right,
it's free.
Yeah, 100%.
Right,
yeah,
we'll look into it for free.
Take a look.
We'll help you out. We'll hook
yeah,
you
yeah,
up.
Yeah, yeah.
We're gonna get those reviews freed up, and yeah, I'm excited to see how many we can get freed
me
up
too,
in
yeah,
this group.
Yeah.
So leave
yeah,
your email in the
yeah,
comments,
yeah,
if you want us to reach out to you with Logan's template to get anything freed up. And we'd also love to see in the comments, right? Like Logan's going to come on a few times. This isn't going to be a one-time thing. We like to call ourselves the super marketing bros.
Yeah.
TM. I just trademarked
yeah,
that.
You
did you hear that? And we're going to have him on multiple times. So if there's anything that we didn't talk about,
yep,
I mean, it's been 50 minutes since we
yep,
started talking, I think.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much more knowledge here. So if there's anything you want us to really focus in on and hone on, or something you're struggling with your organization and your business, marketing related, we'll get Logan back in here. We'll sit down and we can start going through
yep,
those questions.
Absolutely.
So yeah. So anything else you want to add? How can people find you, Logan?
Yeah. I mean, I'm pretty active on Facebook. So just look
yeah,
up Logan Hughes. You see, you know, the green profile pic there, you know, with my face on there. That's the one. Yeah. You know, I communicate a lot through Facebook.
Yeah.
I'm also
ditto,
on Instagram and LinkedIn, but send me a direct message. Mm-hmm. You know, you'll find my phone number and my email on there as well. But yeah, anything through Facebook, you know, I'm always looking to, you know, communicate with everyone, even
yeah,
if it's just, you know, about family stuff.
And I'll
you know,
tag through, you. I'll tag you when we post
sure,
this video
yeah,
so people can find you.
Yeah.
And people can hear your raps.
Yeah, there you go.
Because
yeah,
literally, you might not know this, or you might. And if you do, you've already been blessed.
Yeah, yeah.
That this is the rapping marketer. Maybe next time we'll have you rap.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Yeah.
We'll just freestyle
I
something.
Think, episode 2 is coming out hopefully soon. I got something.
Yeah, I love that.
We'll
I love
happens,
that. So yeah, scroll down in his Instagram and his
yeah,
social media
we'll
videos
see,
and stuff like that. You'll see. You'll see
yeah,
exactly what we're talking
yeah,
about. This guy is a rapper.
Yeah.
He's legit. He's legit. But yeah, anyways, thank you.
Yeah,
really appreciate you coming
yeah,
on. I hope we built some value here.
Yep.
Again, please leave any information in the comments. Mm-hmm. Let us help you. Let us free Let's get these reviews freed up.
Absolutely.
I can't wait to see. I hope it's hundreds, dude. I hope it's hundreds that we were able to help with that. If you have any marketing questions for our next time we have Logan on, throw them in the comments. And thank you for sticking with us for this conversation. Thank you for being in this group. Logan, thank you.
Thanks, brother. Happy meal, man.
God bless. Thanks, everybody.